Hi, I'm Jim Sullivan. I want to give you a quick peek at what our course looks like in Canvas. Even if you're familiar with Canvas, I think it's worthwhile to watch this very brief video to make sure you're operating the way I'm looking for you to function inside our Humanities 250 class site. So, as most of you know, you can get into Canvas in a lot of different ways. Here's one approach from the MiraCosta homepage. You can click on Online Ed. When you do that, you get an Online Ed interface. You click on Canvas. When you click on Canvas, you get our course dashboard. Now, once you get into your dashboard, and that's not our course dashboard, it's your personal dashboard, then you click on our course, Humanities 250. This is what the class should look like when you go in, or something close to this, because I've made changes since I made this video, but it'll look something very close to this. And when you enter this, you can see that I have a very simple design. Now, one thing I recommend is this is a good page for you to bookmark in your browser so that you don't have to go through all those steps I just went through, right? If you have a bookmark, you just click on the bookmark and boom, it takes you right here. Probably ask you for your username and password, your Surf username and password first, but you'll go right here rather than through all those unnecessary pages. Now, this course is very clearly organized on its homepage. We've got our guiding question. This is what we're trying to accomplish. You have information to contact me. You have links to a couple of key course resources. I'll talk more about each of those later. But the heart and soul of the homepage is the calendar, which lists each due date in the course. And by 11:59 p.m. on that due date, you need to have the assignments, the tasks designated on this calendar date completed. So let's click on the first calendar date. That's this Monday, August 21st. And you'll see that there's three different activities on there that you can complete. I give you time estimates for how long I think it will take you to do each one, so you can plan a little bit. But the first deadline is going to be 2 to 2.5 hours. If you don't do the work for this first deadline by 11:59 p.m. on Monday night, I'm going to assume you're absent from class, just like a face-to-face class, and you will be dropped. So if because of some kind of emergency you need a little extra time to complete this first assignment, you really need to reach out to me before midnight on Monday, August 21st, so I don't drop you. That's it. It's a very simple layout, right? You work from our course homepage and you'll always be on track. A couple other things, Canvas Help, awesome tool, round the clock, 24/7 student help. Definitely want to use that if you're stuck in the middle of the night trying to get Canvas to do something and it won't. You also have the MCC Student Help Desk, which is a link and a phone number. Very useful during the working hours, and also when you're dealing with things that maybe aren't Canvas but are on your end of things. Trouble with an email, trouble with your browser, etc. They're really good at helping you puzzle through those access, password, and browser type issues. So help is out there. If you use your Canvas calendar, you will notice that the work for this class does show up on the calendar. And again, it shows up clustered all together. So instead of each task being a separate entry on your calendar, all the work for this class appears in one calendar entry together where you can easily complete it. Students tell me they prefer it that way. I'll be interested in your feedback on that point at the end of the semester. So once again, what is really important to remember is how simply organized our page is and how your best way is to work through the calendar here, even though the calendar option in Canvas is activated. Let's just take a quick look at what a typical activity looks like in this class. So if you click into the syllabus and course introductions activity, you'll see I have a lecture and or some videos for you to watch. And then I ask you to contribute to a discussion. In this first case, it's a video introduction, but almost every IRLD has a lecture and some kind of short discussion activity after it for you to process the lecture. And you'll find that at the bottom of each activity, you can click next and it'll take you right to the next activity due on that same due date. And when you have finished all the activities on a given due date, you will find that at the very end, there's a little celebratory post. So you realize, oh, I got to the end of everything. So there's lots of guidance to make sure you're doing the right work in the right place and the right sequence. Please follow those cues and you'll find our Canvas layout is a really productive one. And good luck to you, and reach out to me if you have any questions. You have my cell phone and email, please use them. See you in the class. See you in Canvas.